first, fast, accurate. You're watching WSBT Channel 22 News at 5:30.
Well, the video is amazing. A massive barn fire that had flames shooting dozens of feet into the air. 18 horses, a donkey, and a show dog died in this Cass County fire yesterday.
More than a dozen fire departments and dozens of firefighters responded, some spending hours on that scene. WSBT-22's Zach Crenshaw is live in Edwardsburg. Zach, this is impacting the entire community.
That's right, Jen. From the neighbor who said he crawled through the barn and could hear the horses neighing and kicking the stables, to the strangers who never knew the families affected, to the students, nearly 3,000 of them, that are going to miss another day of school tomorrow.
It wasn't a typical Wednesday in Edwardsburg.
It has been a unique situation for us.
All schools were closed after last night's barn fire led to a low water level and potential contamination.
We made a decision that let's err on the side of safety for students until we learn more about what contamination, if any, might exist.
Business parking lots weren't as empty.
It has been a huge inconvenience.
As they worked around the boil order.
We've been boiling water, serving just orange juice, milk, chocolate milk, water with no ice.
The fire impacted thousands, none more than the family that lived above the barn.
How can we help? What can we do?
The community has rallied together, creating a Facebook group to organize donations.
All of us out there care and want to make a difference in any way we can. We're hurting a lot.
Tammy Boyer used her role as a bank teller to set up a location for clothes and financial donations for the displaced family.
A lot of people have a lot of emotion going right now, but it takes more than emotion. You have to actually take action, and that's what we're trying to do.
And Tammy says that's what Edwardsburg is all about.
There's an outpouring that happens whenever one of us is hurting, all of us tries to come together in some way or form to help that family.
Now, a lot of people are not a part of that Facebook group that I mentioned, but are still wondering how they can help. I just received word from Tammy that all three branches of the Greater Niles Community Federal Credit Union are now accepting both financial and clothing donations. All those donations are going to the family that managed and lived in that barn and pretty much lost everything. Reporting live in Edwardsburg, Zach Crenshaw, WSBT 22 News.